What's up guys, the Coding Beast here. So today I'm going to redo one of my old tutorials for SteamCMD. So this is going to be about how to download all the Garry's mod content you need for creating your own server. So first off, you have to go to the SteamCMD website. I'll put a link in the description for that. And this tutorial only going to work for Windows users, so you will have to scroll down until you find the Windows download. Click on it and it will download a zip file. Take a few seconds to download. Open it up, and before you do anything with that, you'll have to go to your computer and find somewhere you want your server to be created. I chose to do it in my C drive. I made a folder called Steam, and in there I have a folder called Garry's Mod and SteamCMD. Open up SteamCMD or whatever your folder is called, and drag in CMD. SteamCMD.exe. Now just open up SteamCMD, it will start updating SteamCMD, downloading a lot of files. This takes about a minute, depends on your internet speed. So it's now done downloading and extracting all the files, and now you can see you have a little field down here where you can type. So the first thing you have to type in is login anonymous. And it's important that you don't do any typos in this, unless it won't work. So if they ask for a password, you probably did a typo. So this will connect to the Steam public servers. It takes a few seconds to connect, but let's see. Here we go. Success. So the next thing that type in is /install_dir, make a space, and now you will have to go back to the SteamCMD folder and find the directory where you want your server to be installed to. So I chose to make a Garry's Mod folder here. So now go up here, click on it, right click and copy, or Control C, go back to SteamCMD, right click on the icon, go to edit and paste. It should look like this, and now just hit enter. And the next thing you have to do is type in app_update, then the ID of the game, and Garry's Mod have the ID 4020, and then after that you have to type validate. So this will take, depending on your internet speed, it took about 2 hours, something like that. It really depends on your internet speed, but be prepared on it taking a lot of time. So after that, you'll just have to create the bat file, and we'll do that in the next tutorial. So yeah, thanks for watching. Please comment, rate and subscribe.